Hi, this is Rik Palieri, and welcome to another chapter in the Songwriter's Notebook. I am here with an old friend, an old, old friend that we have known each other since the 1970s, and you have been on this show now three times, and it is wonderful to have you back, Guy Davis, and you brought Fabrizio Poggi with you from Italy, and Fabrizio is a wonderful harmonica player, and we're really honored to have Fabrizio in the studio of the VCAM TV station here in Burlington, Vermont. And we're here to talk about a very, very special project. I mean, you know, you've been playing blues, you know, from, well, when did you start really playing the blues? I mean, you've been playing a lot of music, Guy, but when did you really start playing the blues?
I'd have to say I really got started playing the blues about 37 years ago, but I've been playing music for a good 47.
And what was that first song that when you started playing the blues that, let's say, you took you in a whole different direction?
Well, I got to tell you, that's a two-parter. The first one that I heard that really took me was Bobby Blue Bland singing The Drifting Blues. And I wanted to get into the electric blues. It's back in the 60s, you see. But it was Taj Mahal, the acoustic blues musician, when I heard him doing some of the Robert Johnson stuff and some of his earlier tunes in the late 60s, early 70s. That kind of really turned me on my ear.
Yeah. Yeah, and you know, you've been playing the Lead Belly songs for as long as I've known you. You know, that was a big part. And you know, you both were at the big Lead Belly concert earlier, was that last year? The big tribute in Carnegie Hall, right?
Yep, we got to do that. I got to play Bourgeois Town. And getting back to that 12-string, which you're the owner and player of, We both had some of the same instructors, that being Pete Seeger.
That's right. We'll talk about Pete later on in the program. But, you know, I think that the thing that you guys have done, you've put out a few albums now. Yeah. This is your second album or third album together?
Together, it's our second that he has produced, but he has also been on a third one, mm-hmm. and I've been on one or two of his.
So. And how did you guys meet?
What do we mean? I keep saying it's Switzerland. Fabrizio says it's Italy. But let's just say it's a little over a decade ago. We met somewhere, there was a stage, there was a lot of playing, and we both got together.
Well, you guys are like brothers in blues for sure, and it's really wonderful to hear you play. And you decided, you know, that you would also honor another duo who played blues and harmonica that we all love, and of course that's Sonny Terry and Brownie McGee. And how did this project come to light?
Fabrizio produced this latest CD, and it was his idea. I got to name it Sonny and Brownie's Last Train. And it is, we think of it as a love letter to Sonny and Brownie. It's no competition to them. It's something that people will hear it. Hopefully they'll hear us at our best and say, well, wow, whose song is that? Where'd you get that from? And they will trace it back to Sonny and to Brownie, the two masters, the two originators, the two guys who not only played their own songs, but covered other songs by folks like Big Bill Brunzi and Lead Belly and Elizabeth Cotton and on and on.
Mm. Well, why don't you give us one of those songs right now? Mm.
Fabrizio, what do you say we do? Walk On. This is a song by Brownie McGee and his wife, Ruth. And we think it's sort of the studied conclusion of arguing between a man and a wife. They somehow brought it together in song. Walk On. Here we go.
Back home. Well, You know, it's funny because, you know, usually when you think of an Italian, you don't think of the fact that, you know, he would have a mouthpiece, you see. But Guy, you're being Fabrizio's mouthpiece and telling a little bit about his story because he doesn't have even a mic on. But yeah. He was telling me the other night about that he was inspired by The Last Waltz. The Last Waltz was like sort of the beginning of your musical entry, that you got so excited about this music. And, you know, when you started, you know, playing the harmonica, thinking about, you know, Sonny Terry, you know, and you can hear that kind of Sonny and Terry vibe. And you guys, I want to get in as much music as possible. So you got a song about Hooray, Hooray.
These women is killing me. But I got to tell you about that movie, The Last Waltz, 1981. Yeah. That inspired me quite a bit. Mm. And you had Muddy Waters up there. That's when, in my mind, he became the Pope of the blues. Muddy Waters, okay. But getting over to Sonny. Sonny wrote a song called Hooray, Hooray, These Women Is Killing Me. Disclaimer here, we're crazy about women in all the good ways too. There's songs we sing about low down women, and I just want to say we look up to low down women because if it wasn't for low down women, we wouldn't have a career.
So. All right, Guy, let's do another, let's fit in as much music as we can because we have a lot of things in here. So you have another song, and is this one what you're doing too? Harmonicas?
Two harmonicas on this one. Now, this one is not actually on the CD. This was on my previous CD, Kokomo Kid.
Right.
It was a tribute very much to Sonny called I'm Gonna Shake It Like Sonny Did.
Well, the whole thing that you got to know about Guy, I mean, Guy, you know, Sonny Terry took off in that Finnegan's Rainbow.
Yeah, Finnegan's Rainbow.
Right, good and book. you actually were able to do that kind of in years later and fill in that part of Sonny Terry, correct?
Yeah, on Broadway in New York City.
That's right.
I'm a very lucky fella.
You are a lucky fella. All right, let's hear it.
Okay, I'm gonna shake it like Sonny did. could live in the desert. I could crawl through the sand. I can swim in the ocean or walk on dry land. When it comes to making music, I'm the kid and I'm gonna shake it like Sonny did. I'm gonna build me a rocket and fly up into space. Have all them aliens looking right down in my face. But when they find that rocket and they pop the lid, I'm gonna jump out and shake it like Sonny did. I like to drink bourbon when I sing the blues. But I don't drink government whiskey. I drink that moonshine booze. Police come up, they grab my hand, said, boy, you got your ball and chain. The judge looked at me, said, boy, you doing time. He banged down his gavel, and he gave me 99. His wife spoke up, don't give him a bid, because that man shake it like Sonny did. The judge's face turned red, put his hand on his hip, and he drawed down his pistol, and he poked out his lip. Said, before I let you play me, kid, you'd be shaking all over like Sonny did. Shot a bullet in the floor, and that's when I start to dance. He shot a second bullet, and it almost split my pants. His wife jumped up, pulled out a gun, said, drop it, Judge, I'll give you one.
We got to fit in because I'm trying to fit in that last song at the end there.
Well, man,
we'll see.
If
we'll
we
this.
Can, I'll tell you what we're going to try to do. This song is the title song of the CD that we're promoting. Excuse me for if I'm not on the mic there. Sonny and Brownie's Last Train.
And people can go to your website.
Yes. Yeah, if they want to find out more about any of these CDs, any of our music, any of what we do, go to GuyDavis.com. Just stick those W's where they're supposed to go. Everything's gonna be all right.
All right.
Okay. Two figures stood on the railway platform. The train there was waiting for them. It was Sonny, Terry, Brown, and McGee. They got on board. This train was only for them. Nobody else could ride. And that train began to leave the station. It's the last slow train.
sunny and rainy day going down. Now there were a couple of hobos standing beside the train. And the train was still going slow enough, so they called up to the conductor, "Hey man, can we ride?" The conductor called down, "No man, this train is just for sunny and just for brownie. You can't get on board. It's the last slow train leaving town. It's the last slow train leaving town." You heard the bell rang. Bell rang, whistle blew. Before they disappeared into the night, the conductor called out, "Goodbye, sonny. Goodbye, brownie. See you on the other side."
Thank you, brother.
I'll tell you, that was really beautiful. And it kind of goes along with this last thing. We might be able to fit in if I, this is kind of short.
Oh.
See if we can get this in here. We're there in the key of A.
Key of A. Let's see. I think we can do that.
And just like saying goodbye to Sonny and Brownie, yeah. Both Guy and I were very close to Pete Seeger, and I kind of resisted writing anything about it for a long time or saying anything. So I was surprised when this kind of came to me. But it's based on that old song about Joe Hill. And just like Joe Hill, I think that Pete's gonna live forever. Whenever people get together and sing, whenever people are protesting and standing there, whether they know it or not, Pete's right there with him. And so I was thinking about that, and I kind of did this.
I dreamed I saw Pete Seeger chopping wood today. Said, "Hey Pete, I thought you died." He said, "I didn't. I didn't go away." I said, "Hey Pete, I know you died. I saw it on the news." He said, "It takes more than death to kill a soul. And I've got things to do. I've got lots of things to do." Tall, with love in both his eyes, he set down his axe to relax with Toshi by his side. Toshi was by his side.
Mm-hmm.
strummed on his five-string banjo, then strummed on his guitar, and he poked his head up through the clouds, sang to the stars, he sang up to the stars. So when you look up to the sky after a gentle rain, you know that Pete still working, building his rainbow chain. He's building a rainbow chain. A small Pete Seeger chopping wood today said, "Hey Pete, I thought you died." He said, "Rick, I never went away. No, I never went away." Thank you, Pete Seeger, for all the things that you've done for us.
Amen. Amen.
What do we got? We got just a few minutes, Guy. What are we going to do? What are we going to bring him out with?
My golly. Let's see. What do we have?
You want to do Stepping Up and Go?
We could do Stepping Up and Go. You
know,
in the key of a G.
Oh, we can do that. Go ahead. This is Rik Palieri at the Songwriter's Notebook with Guy Davis and Fabrizio Poggi.
Yes, here we go. Wishing that